Why do you think he kind of had it in for Ken?
I don't think he had it in particularly for Ken, other than the fact that I think he truly, like, I keep going back to this idea, this movie is really about friendship at the most amazing level, even down to seemingly what is the, you know, the villain of the piece in Leo Beebe, partly was that he was such extraordinary friends with Henry Ford II. They'd been in a tank together in the military. They'd sort of grown up together, that he believed ultimately in his friend, the same way that Ken Miles and Shelby had that relationship. So, but also at the same time, I think he was the sort of guy who, you know, looking at a bigger political context, was a loyalist, truly, and a sense of, like, he saw the Ford Company as the greatest company in the world, which at the time it was the apple of its day, and that he believed in its message to America as an image, as a sense of stability and wholesomeness and all those different things that, you know, the bohemian sort of hippie element of the Ken Miles of it all, or the sort of independent radical Shelby type character, struck him as like, wait a second, but we bought you, you know, so we own you, so we can tell you what to do. And that's just the facts of it. So I don't think it came from necessarily such a villainous place. It was much more just like a clear-cut sense of what his honor was. And yet, obviously, it was hard. I think I was talking to a Christian about this last night. It's very hard when you morally and totally disagree with your character, but to try and find a way in, you know, try and find, like, who is this guy for real?
I like antagonist, but bad guys, I don't think it helps the actor playing, because a bad guy to, because no one wakes up and goes, I'm going to do shitty things to nice people today. That's really not how people wake up, who do what we perceive as bad things. They're, like Josh says, he's protecting the company. He's protecting the company's image. He's there. Why are they doing this race? They're not doing it to win the race and make Ken Miles in the record books. They're doing it to sell cars. Yeah. So anything that's a threat to selling cars is a threat to the reason they're there. Therefore, their battle, their agenda is to sell cars, and that it's really that simple. And any movie company selling a movie isn't going to let anything trample in its way. Meaning that every company has an agenda, a capitalist agenda that's very simple. That, and sometimes money and ideals don't align. And but that really, I think that's important to me, because I think that the movies get cheapened when even doing bad things gets cheapened. Morality gets cheapened when we just go, that's an evil person, as opposed to trying to understand why they're doing this. Because if we don't understand why people are doing wrong things or things we don't like, then we won't ever be able to stop it, because we just assume they were somehow born with a black dot on their head, you know, of evil or something.
That photograph of the three cars crossing at the exact same time is an iconic image in the history of sports. That was a brilliant...
See, he's still in character. Yeah. It's like, I did it! It's a Wheaties box!